Assalamu alaikum class. Today we are going to discuss the fifth lecture of biostatistics, and the topic under discussion will be z-score. We have already discussed the normal distribution curve and how this curve represents the presentation of variables in a normal healthy population. We have discussed that what are the properties of these this curve, that it is unimodal, it is symmetrical, it is bell-shaped, the mean, median and mode are in the center, and it is always equal to zero. And we all know that the total area of the curve is one, standard deviation of this curve is one. And then we have discussed that around the mean, the values are dispersed with a standard deviation of plus minus one standard deviation, plus minus two standard deviation, and plus minus three standard deviation. And we have already discussed that 68% of the population lies between the plus minus one standard deviation around the mean in the normal distribution curve. And we have already discussed that 95% of the population lies between plus minus two standard deviation of the curve. And whenever we extend towards the plus minus three standard deviation in a normal distribution curve, we are covering the 99% of the population. Today we will be discussing that what is z-score and how do we do interpretation of z-score in a normal distribution curve. So moving forward, this is the normal distribution curve. We have discussed it in detail that it is bell-shaped, it is smooth, it is symmetrical. Ideally, the tapering tails should never touch the base line. And when we the mean, median and mode lie in the center, and it is always equal to zero in a normal distribution curve. When we talk about the plus one and minus one standard deviation, we cover 68% of the data. When we cover the plus two and minus two standard deviation, we cover the 95% of data. And when we go towards the plus three and minus three standard deviation, we cover 99.7% of the data. This presents the normal distribution of population, whatever variable we want to discuss, or whatever variable is the intention of the researcher, it is always distributed in this normal distribution curve. So this is the normal distribution curve. We have already discussed it, and we all know that this center makes the mean, median and mode in a normal distribution curve. If the values are skewed towards the right, the mean is always mean, it will move towards the right. And the mode will show the height of the curve. If there is skewness on the left side of the normal distribution curve, the mean will move towards the left. And between mean and mode, there will be median of the normal distribution curve. Fine. So this is the multiple number of observations which are done in a population. When we draw a normal distribution curve, these values vary from the mean. They are present scattered in the population. As you can see that the variable count is measured by the value of x. So these variables are scattered. They are distributed in the normal distribution curve. Some of them are lying close to the mean and some of them are far from the mean. Fine. So look at this now, that this X bar represents the mean of the data. Let me emphasize that normal distribution curve, usually we deal with quantitative data. And when we talk about the quantitative data, we calculate the mean, median and mode. We calculate the dispersions, and the measures of dispersion include the range, mean deviation, variance and standard deviation. So the values which are observed from different people in the sample are presented with the values of x. And when we take mean of all these values, it is represented by x bar. In a normal distribution curve, the mean, median, and mode will lie in the center, as you can see, and they are always equal to zero. And how do we calculate mean? We will sum up all the observations of these people, and we will divide them by the total number of observations to get the mean, which is represented by x bar. Moving forward, now we want to know, after calculating the standard deviation, which is represented here as plus 1 and minus 1, plus 2 and minus 2, plus 3 and minus 3. Now we want to know that how each value is different from the mean in terms of standard deviations. How much this value differ from the mean, how much this value differ from the mean, and how much this value differ from the mean in terms of standard deviations, which will be calculated by the z-score. So what is z-score? Z-score is calculated by the x, means the value of an individual person which is taken from the sample, minus mean, which is sometimes represented by x bar and it is sometimes represented by mu. If you are taking the population mean, you will take mu, and if you will take the sample mean, you will take it as x bar. This is the representation which is known as sigma, is the representation of standard deviation. So whenever we want to calculate the z-score, the formula will be x minus mu over sigma, or the other formula can be x minus x bar over s. Again, the s represents the symbol of standard deviation. Sometimes the standard deviation is written by s dot capital D. Sometimes it is written by s. Sometimes it is represented by the sigma sign. And this x bar represents the mean of the sample. And if we are talking about the mean of the population, we replace this x bar with the mu. But the formula of the z-score remains the same. So we calculate z value, which tells us about the difference of each observation from the mean in terms of standard deviations. So this is a data set in which we have calculated multiple numbers for the as the numerical data. And for this data, I will request you to calculate mean and calculate standard deviation. This is your task one. For this data, calculate mean, which is the measure of central tendency, and calculate standard deviation, which is the measure of dispersion. Moving forward, let's suppose that we have taken a sample and the sample mean is equal to 99.68 and the standard deviation of this sample is 13.61. So we have made another observation that another variable which is present in this particular sample shows the value of 59. Now I want to know that how much this value differs from the mean in terms of standard deviation, and this will be calculated on terms of calculation of z-score. Z-score will also tell us about how this particular value is located in the normal distribution curve for this particular data. So let's move forward. If the mean is 99.68 and standard deviation is equal to 13.61, how do we calculate the z-score? The z-score will be equal to x minus x bar over standard deviation, which is the x bar is the mean and standard deviation is actually 13.61. So we want to calculate x. Fine. So if we want to calculate the x, we want to see that z into standard deviation, we will measure it. And you can see it that the value of x can be calculated by x bar plus minus 1 into standard deviation. Fine. So if my mean is 99.68 and this is plus minus 1 and standard deviation is 13.61. So by doing 99.68 plus 13.6 and 99.68 minus 13.6, one, I will get the range of 86.07 to 113.29. It means that 68% of the observations in this data set will lie between these values. Fine. So now I want to calculate that how do the values are dispersed in measure of two standard deviation. So mean is 99.68 plus minus 2 into standard deviation is 13.61. And by adding it and subtracting it, I will get the value that 72.46 to 126.9. It means 95%. Now I am talking about two standard deviations. So 95% of the values will lie between these confidence limits. This is my lower confidence limit. This is my upper confidence limit. So I'm 95% confident that the value set between 95% of the data, which represents two standard deviation, will lie between this range. The value of confidence limit for 68%, the lower limit is this and the upper limit is this. It means I'm 68% confident that the value set between the one standard deviation will lie between this range. So let's move towards the three standard deviations. The three standard deviation range gives us 99.68 plus minus 40.83, and it will give me the range of 58.85 to 140.51. It means if I go back, I wanted to find out the location of X, which was 59. So I have got a range of 58.85 to 140.51. It means that if I will talk about plus minus three standard deviations, my 99% of the observations will lie between this. And when I talk about the value of 59, it is almost present at the value of three standard deviation, minus three standard deviation in the data set. Have you understood the example? Let's go back. We have a mean value. We have standard deviation. On the basis of mean and standard deviation, we will calculate the values of confidence intervals. When we have calculated the values of confidence intervals, the one mean plus minus one standard deviation will give us the confidence interval of 68%. X bar plus minus 2 standard deviation will give us the values of 95% confidence interval, and x is equal to x bar plus minus 3 standard deviation will give us 99% confidence interval. Now we will see that the value which we wanted to find out, which was 59 in this case, where it is located in the sample. So we see that it was not present in this range. It was not present in this range. It is very, very close to this. And this value has been taken by subtracting the minus 3 standard deviation from the mean. It means 59 is present almost at the minus 3 standard deviation of the data set, which covers the 99% of the observations. And we are 99% confident that in this total data set, when we talk about this total data set, the values range between 58.85 to 140.51. Clear? Okay. So how do we again calculate a z-score? By the method that we have mean, we have standard deviation. The z-score is calculated by x minus x bar over standard deviation. X was 59 in our case. Mean was 99.68 and standard deviation was 13.61. While calculating it, we have calculated this value, which is equal to minus 2.98, which is almost equal to minus 3. It means the presence of value of 59 according to our z-score is present at the minus 3 standard deviation in the normal set. Clear? So both the procedures can be adopted. Okay, moving forward, how do we interpret the value of z-score? If you go and look into this data set, that this value is minus 2.98. The exact value of z-score is minus 2.98. So what we will do, in the z-score are present in the left extreme column, and then there are values of p which are present. So our value was 2.9. The z-score was 2.9. And when we vertically go down in this column, this value is 2.9. Fine. Going back, it is 2.98 minus 2.98. So in 2.9, we will go into the column of 0.08. So with 2.9, we will trace out the value here. And in this column, it is 0.4986. This value gives us the interpretation of z-score in terms of p-value. So this is 0.4986 in this case. Let me repeat again. The z-score is present in the left-hand side column and the p-values are present in the rows, and the value which we get of the z-score was minus 2.98. So we will go towards the 2.9. And we will vertically horizontal, we will go in horizontal row, and we will see that what is the value of 0.08, which is 0.4986. So how will you interpret this table? This is the normal distribution curve. We know that 68% of the population lies between the plus minus one standard deviation. If you divide the 68% into two equal halves, it makes 34% and 34%. And if we go into plus 2 and minus 2 standard deviation, it will form the 95% of the observations. So when we divide the 95 into two halves, it makes 47.5% and 47.5%. And if we further go with the 99.7%, it will make almost 49.85% and 49.85%. Let me go back with the value. It was 0.4986. So when we plot it into this graph, it was minus value. So it will be lying somehow here. The z-score shows that in a normal distribution curve, it will be lying in the negative z-score. And it will be almost equal to 49.86, which is minus 3 standard deviation. This is the way how we interpret the value of z-score in a normal distribution curve. So this is your assignment 2. In Sender for 4th year MBBS class, the class showed mean and standard deviation of scores in subjects as follows. Two send-ups were taken, community medicine and pathology. And the mean score of the class in community medicine was 67 with the standard deviation of plus minus 8. And the mean score of class of 4th year MBBS in pathology was 58 with the standard deviation of 12. Now, we want to know that what is the z-score of Rafia Tariq performance. Rafia Tariq scored 86 in community medicine out of 100 and she scored 61 in pathology out of 100. So now I want to know that what is the z-score of Rafia Tariq's performance and how will you interpret the results? This is your assignment 2. So you will be finishing your assignments within half an hour of the once I will conclude my lecture, and you will be submitting it within half an hour, and we will mark you present if you will submit your assignment on time. Thank you so much. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, you can always contact me. Thank you so much.